In some places, like Taiwan, pe plus ng does make peng, as in 朋友, meaning friend. In mainland China, that is pronounced 朋友, but you can choose which accent you want to learn. 大家好, welcome to Sing and Learn Chinese. This is the third video in the Learn to Speak Chinese Syllable series. There are over 400 syllables in Chinese, and once you know these syllables, along with the Chinese tones, you'll be able to pronounce every word that exists in Mandarin Chinese. If you're totally new to Chinese, check out the How Chinese Works video, which will give you the foundational knowledge you need to understand the rest of this video. And for the rest of you, I'll assume that you already know the basics of Chinese pronunciation, including pinyin, zhuyin, and tones. In this video, we'll be going over the Chinese syllables and words from the third column of the Chinese pronunciation chart, which you can grab for free from singandlearnchinese.com, link below. If you want, you can pause the video and grab your copy now, or after you finish watching. Okay, let's do this. Words that start with a Chinese sound, pe. Let's start with pe plus a, pa, as in 害怕, to be afraid, 害怕. Then pe plus o is a little tricky. It makes the sound po, not po, but po, as in 巫婆, which, 巫婆. I don't know why, it's just one of those pronunciation things you need to learn. Next, we have pe plus I, pai, as in 排队, meaning to get in line, to line up or to key up. 排队. Then pe plus a makes pei, as in 配菜, or side dish. 配菜. Pe plus ao is pao, as in 大炮, or cannon. 大炮. Now we come to another odd syllable. Pe plus o makes po. Anatomy is 解剖学. But the thing is, a lot of Chinese speakers, especially those in Taiwan, don't say 解剖学. They say 解剖学. So po is the same sound as 巫婆, which that we talked about earlier. I don't know why Chinese does this. It's just one of those things to remember, depending on where you are. 解剖学, 解剖学, they both work. All right, moving on. Pe plus an makes pan, as in 盘子, a plate. 盘子. Then pe plus n is pen, as in 打喷嚏, to sneeze. 打喷嚏. Notice that even though it's spelled P-E-N, the word is pronounced pen, not pen, as in the English word for the thing that you write with. Not pen, it's pen. Same thing with pang, which is made of the sounds pe plus ang. It's not pronounced pang, as in a pang of conscience, but pang, as in 旁边, which means to the side of. So, 我走在你旁边 means I'm walking next to you. 旁边. Okay, now, pe plus ng makes pong, as in 烹饪, which is a fancy way to say cook. Now, usually we just say 煮饭, but if you want to say that your hobby is cooking, you can use 烹饪. Now, why doesn't it make 烹? Well, that depends on regional accents. In some places, like Taiwan, 泼 plus 嗯 does make 烹, as in 朋友, meaning friend. In mainland China, that is pronounced 朋友, but you can choose which accent you want to learn. 朋友, 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 eh. Both work. Next, pe plus e makes p, as in 皮带, or belt. Literally, leather belt, but it can refer to generic belts as well. 皮带. Then, pe plus ye makes pie, as in 撇开, meaning to set aside. It was kind of tricky to find a good picture to represent this, but since the word basically means to put away or to ignore something, I found a picture of a woman stuffing things into a bag, maybe for storage or maybe to throw it away. 撇开. Next, we have pe plus yao, which makes the sound piao, and piao means to float or drift. Now, there are two ways to write this word. There's one that you see here, which means to float on the wind, and this piao means to drift on the water. They both use a similar radical, as you can see circled here, only the second part of each character is different, indicating which one is wind and which one is water. For more information about radicals, make sure you check out the How Chinese Works video, link below. Okay, next we have pe plus yi plus an, which makes 片 as in 影片, a film or a movie. 影片. Note that is 片, not 片. I don't know why, it's just the way things are. So 影片. And p plus e plus n makes 贫 as in 贫穷, which means poverty or poor. 贫穷. Finally, p plus e plus n makes 苹, as in 苹果, apple, 苹果. And if you've watched our previous videos in the series, you already know that there is basically no difference between the pronunciation of P-I-N and P-I-N-G for many Chinese speakers, especially those in Taiwan, unless you want to emphasize the N-G in 苹, like this, 苹, 苹 versus 苹, 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 苹. Personally, I just say them the same. 贫穷, 苹果. But that's just my particular accent, and that's how I learned with the people around me. You can choose your own way. And that's it. You learned all of the p syllables that exist in Chinese. Once you start combining these syllables with the correct tones, you can start speaking real Chinese. As always, remember to grab your free copy of the entire Chinese pronunciation chart from singandlearnchinese.com, and I will see you in the next video. Until we sing again, 再见.